Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Before we get started with the commentary in today's video, I just want to let y'all know that I'm using a new microphone, and this is going to be my new microphone from here on out. So I'd really like to know what y'all think about my audio quality down below in the comments section. If there's anything that I need to tweak, do I need to change anything for your listening pleasure? I decided to finally, after about 4.5 to 5 years, upgrade from my old XLR mic to a Shure SM7B, which is what every major podcast use. I've seen radio hosts use this microphone, and I believe that they recorded Michael Jackson's Thriller with this microphone, so that's a pretty cool backstory. I just want to point out this is also not an advertisement. I'm just really happy with the quality of this mic, and I would definitely suggest it to anybody out there looking to get a huge upgrade. With that said, though, let's move on to today's video. Let's talk a little bit about the things that you should do before the rank reset comes into effect. Now, for those of you that are unfamiliar with what's going to happen, let me quickly explain. On December 3rd, when Season 1 starts in Call of Duty Modern Warfare, everyone's rank will be reset back down to level 55. If you haven't reached level 55 yet, your rank won't be touched. You're just going to continue ranking up like normal. The only other thing that's going to reset is the officer rank challenges. You will not have the same set of officer rank challenges come December 3rd. After this one's done, that's it. They're going into the vault forever. But the good news is nothing else is being touched. Your rank on your weapons will not be touched. Your camouflage grind will not be touched. Your attachments will not be reset. All of that will remain the same, and you will continue that progress like normal. I've seen a lot of people freaking out over this reset, not understanding whether or not that stuff is going to go away. And the definitive answer is, directly from Infinity Ward, no, none of that will be reset. Oh yeah, and one more thing. These challenges and missions will not reset either. If you're in progress of completing one to earn a blueprint, your progress will remain. It will not be reset. So the first thing that you should do before this reset comes, try to make your way to rank 155. Double XP is going right now, and if you use your little tickets for the trials, you can earn some bonus XP in a small amount of time. Once you reach level 155, you will be given the OG blueprint variant. This is important because once this rank gets reset, there will be no other way to earn this variant. It's going to be completely removed from the game, or maybe added into a shop where you have to pay for it later on down the line. We don't know how they're going to reintroduce content that's already made its way out of the game. I'm assuming when this reset comes through and you make it to 155 again, there will be a new blueprint variant waiting for you at the end of that grind. And just as a reminder, to reiterate this, it doesn't matter if you're rank 154. If it hits 10 a.m. Pacific time on December 3rd and you're rank 154, you're going to be pushed all the way back to level 55 and you're going to miss out on getting that OG blueprint. So if you only have a few levels to go, I highly recommend trying to use those trial tickets, get that extra XP, or complete those officer rank challenges to give you bonus XP while you're normally playing. If you're good at one life modes as well, cyber attack and search and destroy are very good ways to earn a lot of XP in a small amount of time. But your best bet is to complete those officer rank challenges that you haven't done, since you could do multiple in a single match, and doing those trials to earn that extra XP within a short amount of time. The next thing that you should focus on, and it's the most obvious one, completing the officer rank challenges. And admittedly, there are some challenges in there that are pretty dang difficult to do. For example, there is a challenge called Resistance, and it asks you to defend a single objective 5 times in one life. This means killing 5 attackers while you're standing on a flag or watching the headquarters, or even if you're on a hard point. The way that I did this personally was by playing a match of Ground War. Obviously, there are a lot of people that are going to come your way, so I would suggest, and I know that it's playing like a pussy if you do this, but put down claymores at the entrances, wait for them to come to you, let the claymore pop off and kill them or damage them, and just watch your back. I know that that sounds like such a pussy way to play, but that is how I got the challenge to pop. I couldn't get it to work any other way. I don't know why, but using claymores seemed to work. We also know, officially from Joe Seacott now, that you will indeed get some sort of animated emblem from completing all of these ribbons at the beginning of the new season. In my mind, I'm going to treat these like prestige emblems. That means every single season, my emblem will update reflecting what I've done from the previous season. At least that's how I think of it in theory, until a newer, cooler, better-looking emblem comes out and I want to switch back or switch to a different one. I guess that's one of the good things. We can switch it on the fly. I just wish that it was the actual emblem on our rank rather than the standard Commander 5 stars. Who knows what will happen in the future, though? I guess we'll find out. I know this was a short video, but this was basically just a PSA for anybody out there scared or concerned that they were going to lose all of their stuff. I just wanted to reiterate it because December 3rd is quickly approaching us, and we currently have double weapon XP and double XP. So ranking up those weapons to get those difficult ones out of the way, or just trying to get to rank 155 while you can, take this opportunity and try to do it as quickly as you can. With that said, guys, I want to thank you all so much for coming out to today's video. Like I said, I know it was just a recap video, but I appreciate all of the support. Let me know what y'all think about the microphone. I appreciate it. Drop a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more coming each and every day. If you're new to the channel or you have not yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.